When it's hot and muggy, the subway sucks. When you're kinda sweaty and all fed up with the rush hour traffic in Times Square, why does anyone drive there? Because it's New York City and everything has a golden feeling in the spring, and it's not a very pretty town. But have another look around. Why don't we grab a slice or two of that New York pizza? It's only a matter of time. There's grease on my shirt and sauce on my jacket, and the city feels like mine. No matter how many places I travel, there's no place I'd rather be. Some people spend their whole lives trying to get here. I guess I'm just lucky. I've got the Beacon Theater across the street, and just a few stops down is MSG. It's the city of perpetual lights. It's the city of insatiable nights. Why don't we grab a slice or two of that New York pizza? It's only a matter of time. There's grease on my shirt and sauce on my jacket, and the city feels like mine. No matter how many places I travel, there's no place I'd rather be. Some people spend their whole trying to get here. I guess I'm just lucky. I know someday I'll have to leave, but I won't forget the city that never sleeps. And someday I'll come back, I'll come back. Come back, I won't be alone. And while we're at it, and while we're at it, and when I come back, a slice or two of that New York pizza, it's only a matter of time. There's grease on my shirt and sauce on my jacket, and the city feels like mine. No matter how many places I travel, there's no place I'd rather be. Some people spend their whole lives trying to get here. I guess I'm just lucky. I guess I'm just lucky.
Mama, I've been feeling sick. Maybe it's 'cause all I've done this week is stay at home and click. I've been watching all my friends through screens, and it's getting hard to tell when it's getting late and I should get some sleep. No, I don't wanna see what's on the news. I'm so sick of all these views, when I just wanna be with you, and I'll dream of better days. I don't wanna stay in, and I don't want to be afraid, 'cause I wanna be with you, and I'll miss you through the phone. Yeah, we're miles apart, but you know that we're not alone. 'Cause I'm always here with you on memories I'm looking back, thinking when the hell did all this change, and a month goes by like that. I'm running out of things to pass the days. There's only so much time I got with you. You're still living in my head. You should be next to me instead, and I'll dream of better days. I don't wanna stay in, and I don't want to be afraid. Cause I wanna be with you, and I'll miss you through the phone. Yeah, we're miles apart, but you know that we're not alone. Cause I'm always here with you, and I'm so sick of looking back. And I hate being attached. Ooh, come back to me. Ooh, come back to me. And I'm still dreaming of better days. I don't wanna stay in, and I don't want to be afraid. Cause I wanna be with you, and I'll miss you through the phone. Yeah, we're miles apart, but you know that we're not alone. Cause I'm always here with you.
That was amazing.
Bring it on. And we're hoping to win, but our joy comes from within. Bring it on.
Adorable.
Bring it on, bring it on.
Before we begin our ceremony, we would like to extend a heartfelt thank you to the Stuyvesant Alumni Association and to its presidents, Mr. Soo Kim.
The Alumni Association graciously funded the production of the ceremony, and without their continued support, we would not have been able to create it.
And with that, please enjoy.
Good afternoon to all the seniors of the class of 2020, their families, and additionally the beloved faculty and staff of Stuyvesant High School. Welcome to the first ever virtual graduation of Stuyvesant High School. I'm Hannah Kim, one of the co-presidents of the senior grade.
And I'm Zainab Bromberg, your other class co-president. At the beginning of this year, we decided that our senior slogan would be Making History, which turned out to be very relevant.
Well, I had suggested Zoom. If we had 2020 vision, maybe it would have made the cut.
Maybe. Anyhow, while we are saddened that we could not do it in person, we're still determined to make the best of this virtual ceremony. Without further ado, we hand it off to Miss Lilia Shemazov and the seniors of the combined Stuyvesant choruses singing Carrick Fergus, an Irish folk song.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Shimaza and the chorus, for providing us with that lovely performance. Now let's hear Principal Contreras share a few words with us.
Greetings, class of 2020, distinguished members of the Stuyvesant faculty, and family members and loved ones of our graduates. I am Eric Contreras, principal at Stuyvesant High School. To our graduates, 4 years ago, as you began your journeys as members of our spectacular school community, on that same day, I began serving as your new and very excited principal. We were both eager and impressed and in awe at the privilege of being part of Stuyvesant. We entered this path together as you took your first step on the blue carpet at the entrance, bearing our motto, Proscientia atque sapientia. I greeted you at the door and met you for the first time at Camp Stuyvesant. We began at Stuyvesant together, and now we celebrate our journeys together. We close 4 years in which I've had the privilege of seeing you grow, learn, and become the exemplary graduates you are today. You have grown literally and figuratively on the Stuyvesant stage. You are stars in your own right, and how fitting that Hollywood was the theme for Sing. I now get to roll out the red carpet and celebrate you and all your accomplishments. You now move toward your next big stage. We, the staff, your family members, and myself now get to be the paparazzi, capturing this moment as your talented class moves beyond high school. We get to see you one by one walk across our virtual stage, and we sit in awe at all you have accomplished. Take this moment to look toward your family members and loved ones and thank them for all the love and support they have given you over the years. Take another moment to thank the staff members who have supported and mentored you over the years. You graduate during trying times for our city, state, country, and global community. As you leave Stuyvesant, and as your senior year comes to a close, you have sacrificed a great deal. However, we will look back and remember this as an opportunity to grow and to acknowledge the many ways I know you will shape and improve our society going forward. Graduates are often told to celebrate academic success through a specific lens that values fortune and fame over community and contribution. What the challenges at the twilight of your high school experience have taught us is that we are all intricately connected and interwoven in a vast web of mutuality. The heroes during our current pandemic have been workers previously uncelebrated. These daring souls have, during a challenging time, kept us safe, healthy, transported, and fed. And they risk their own lives to make sure that our society keeps moving forward. It will be up to your generation to make sure that they are not merely called essential workers, but they are truly valued and they are given salaries and benefits and the ability to protect their own families and have the essential things they need to fully participate in our nation's great democracy. You have also witnessed this year the heroic voices of young people standing up against racism and injustice to demand more of ourselves, our school, and our city, and our country, in our long and far from finished work in achieving racial equity. Young voices that have declared rightly and justly that Black lives matter. If there's a group of intelligent, driven, and caring graduates who can correct some of the injustices of past generations, it is your class, the class of 2020. In your time at Stuyvesant, you have collaborated, supported, and mentored each other. You have rooted for each other and worked in unison in athletics and academics. In and out of school, you have been champions for each other. You have done this as mentors and as members in many organizations, such as BSL, Aspida, Spectrum, and MSA, and through teams such as robotics, speech and debate, Scioli, chess, Model UN, math, and science research. Your concern for each other is evident in the support you have given each other as tutors in Arista and as mentors in Big Sibs. The volunteer efforts for local and global causes as members of our many service organizations. Your independent journalism in The Spectator. Your outspoken advocacy efforts for important causes and your work for a more sustainable and equitable planet tell everyone, we will be heard. You have loudly stated, we will take care of each other. We will correct the mistakes of yesterday. You have made it clear that you value our greater human fabric, spirit, and family. Your many acts of kindness and collective work look not like individual ripples, but a wave of positive deeds and actions. The world needs you now more than ever. As you leave Stuyvesant, we unfurl the red carpet for you. And we know that your work and your contributions to come will help us live to the ideals of our democracy and promote justice, equality, and peace. Congratulations, class of 2020. You are the true stars in the real scripts of our lives. We need you now more than ever. I wish you the best always. Your proud principal, Eric Contreras.
Thank you so much, Principal Contreras, for that lovely message. Next up, we have our incredible faculty speaker, Mick Stuyvesant. This is Mick Stuyvesant's third year as an English teacher at Stuy.
Though their time here has been short, they've had an incredible impact on the student body, and we are so honored to have them as a faculty speaker.
Hello, friends, family, guests, my Stuy community, and hello to my dearest class of 2020. I've missed you. Yes, I'm bald now. Clearly, I'm shocked you chose me to speak at your graduation today, too. But really, when I heard you wanted me to speak today, I was simultaneously moved and a little surprised. An honor like this has never before been bestowed upon me. And I wondered, why me? I'm young. I'm the new kid on the block. After all, if you don't already know, you're my first official class ever, class of 2020. You saw me on day one of my career. I was sweaty and nervous. I felt like there were so many things I didn't know. If you've been a student in my class, maybe you've heard me say that. I don't know. Maybe you've asked me the definition of a word and I said, I don't know. Maybe you realized I misread something in class or misinterpreted something. Maybe you helped me understand and I said, I didn't know that. Maybe you were in my class when I mispronounced Telemachus as Telemachus for months. You taught me things about ancient Greece, the Cold War, art, music, culture, and the world outside that I didn't know before. We said a lot of I don't know to each other. We learned from each other. The reason I say I don't know, and the reason I like to say it, is because if I don't know something, then there must be an opportunity for me to still know it. Sometimes we get embarrassed about not knowing. Embarrassed to say something wrong in class, sometimes we get defensive, sometimes we're arrogant. But the way I see it, saying I don't know also means I want to know, I can know, help me know. Since I've come to Stuyvesant, I've realized how much there still is for me to know. I've learned so much about the world, our city, different people and different ways of life. Stuyvesant makes me want to know more, and it shows me that, with an open mind, I can. I've also been inspired by your open-mindedness. I've learned from you and with you. When I became Mick Stuyvesant, you were my allies, my community, a support system. I am constantly moved by your ability and desire to work towards understanding and empathy. But these past few months of upheaval have reminded me of how much we all still have to learn. I've sought solace in you as much as you have in me. I don't have all of the answers. It feels impossible to articulate what has been going on and what was lost when we never had a chance to say proper goodbyes after almost 4 years of hard work, 4 years of being a family. So before I go further, I want to take a moment to acknowledge the ineffable. Close your eyes. Yes, actually close them. If your family's in the room, let them give you a little space. Get comfortable in your chair, on your couch. Take a deep breath. Take a minute to appreciate and be proud of what it took for you to be here today. The people who helped you along the way, the late nights and the long days, the hard work you did. Take a minute to reflect on some of what you lost these past few months, what you should have had. Prom, the senior bar countdown, crush lists, senior portraits, senioritis. Reflect on all of the in-class naps you missed. Just kidding. You've missed a lot, and it's not fair. But you've also achieved a lot, and you need to be proud of that. When I first thought about my parting words of advice, I thought about the baller Latin teacher at my own high school, Mr. Hansenbrook, who gave the faculty speech at my high school graduation. In his speech, he said that we had gone to school, studied hard, and struggled in order to prepare to survive the zombie apocalypse. To survive in a world that wants to eat us up. When I was in high school, I found this allegory charming. Yeah, life's going to be hard, of course. Today this resonates with me differently though, more deeply. The world truly wants to eat us in 2020. We are fighting to survive and be human every day. You know this by looking outside. You know this because your lives are not easy. Many of you travel 2 hours a day to school. Many of you have been cooking for your siblings, sharing devices, working in your parents' stores. Many of you have witnessed and experienced injustice, racism, discrimination. Many of you have seen your loved ones lose jobs, joys, lives. These tragedies are impossible to fathom, especially for people so young. And for people so young, you have just generally survived so much. You're the class that sat in school for 9 hours in lockdown when people were senselessly killed outside of our building. You also came back to school the next morning and hugged each other and cried together. You have never given up hope for a brighter future. You walked out of school in a strike of unprecedented numbers to protect your lives and your rights after countless school shootings. You rallied at City Hall for climate change with Greta Thunberg. You won Sing during a worldwide pandemic. There are protests outside your windows, and yet you organize meetings on Zoom to discuss justice and equity. The world is changing, and it's hard. You've experienced your own apocalypses, and you know survival on many different scales. But the idea of a zombie apocalypse specifically also resonates with me differently in 2020. Mr. Hansenbrook said zombies are unthinking, ravenous beings. They consume without intent. There are lots of zombies out there right now. They're ignorant and greedy and arrogant. How do I know? Because sometimes I am one. In class, I say I don't know because sometimes I'm ignorant. Sometimes I zombie walk through life on autopilot. The only way to move forward and make the world a better place, though, is to acknowledge that and defeat ignorance and indifference, to kill the zombie within and without. How do we do that? We work tirelessly to be more human. Being human means transcending our primitive selves and our innate default of not knowing and not caring. The only thing standing in the way of you vanquishing your ignorance is you. John Shanley says in his play Doubt, "Life happens when the tectonic power of your speechless soul breaks through the dead habits of the mind. Doubt is nothing less than an opportunity to re-enter the present." This is hard to saddle up for. Ignorance is the default. It's easy. To be conscious is to choose to see things for what they truly are, and what things truly are won't always be pretty. You will often have been wrong. Doubt is uncomfortable, intimidating, maybe even upsetting. You may feel angry with yourself, with others. But doubt is human. Doubt means you are thinking for yourself. Doubt means you believe in something better. Don't spend more time fearing your own discomfort than you do challenging yourself to know more. You've been taught at Stuyvesant that you can always know more, and that to know more is to be better, even when it's difficult. Ignorance is cured when you spend time trying to understand what you do not. And the wonderful thing about understanding is, once you have it, you can share it. You can communicate your love and humanity and inspire others to be thinking and understanding and human too. Love is efficient like that. Love is revolutionary like that. John Steinbeck says in The Grapes of Wrath that the individual soul is nothing outside of the group soul. If one individual matters, we all do. What matters to us is who matters to us. We are interdependent. Other people make us whole. We live for our parents, our siblings, our friends, grandparents, mentors, neighbors, our communities. People are the point. When you think, how can I make the world better for me? You must think, how can I make the world better for you? We can't erase the painful things, the injustice, the suffering, the violence, the grief. But there has been so much good too. Human nature is good, and I have seen so much good in you. I've seen you teach and learn from each other, love and hold each other, build footbridges and pick each other up when they broke. And I know you have seen your own humanity and the humanity of your Stuyvesant community too. Think about your unwaveringly supportive parents and guardians trying to give you some breakfast as you sleepily stagger out the door. Think about walking up to the bridge to see smiling faces breathing in the cold, waiting for the front doors to open at 7:30 in the morning. Think about swiping in, saying hello to the school safety guards and the front desk squad. Think about waving to Dr. Haber and Mr. Contreras. Think about running up and down 10 flights of stairs all day in a full sweat, about walking through the halls and seeing the faces of all the friends you love and cherish. Think about your routines, your secret handshakes, your inside jokes. Think about the times when you laughed the hardest at Stuyvesant. It's so important to laugh right now, even though it's so hard to. Personally, I'm thinking about our collective wacky literary conspiracy theories that we used to take way too far. I'm thinking about when you would get to the classroom before I did in the morning and draw anime and write poems on the board. I'm thinking about full-on, in class, with all of the props, Macbeth versus Macduff sword fighting, and someone lifting a desk chair by one leg straight over their head to intimidate Eddie Carbone. I'm thinking about you teaching me how to dap up, teaching me all of the Gen Z slang I never knew I needed in my vernacular. I'm thinking about you spilling iced coffees and food all over my room. I'm thinking about your memes and your smiling faces in the hallway. You have met incredible people at Stuyvesant, and you have grown and learned and loved together. You are prepared for the zombie apocalypse. I have seen the humanity you are capable of. And beyond being ready, you are needed by your communities, your friends, even your country. You all have the power to invest in life and make it better for everyone. You inspire me to fight and to be human. It's been incredible to get to know you and to know myself better in turn. It's been a privilege to learn with you and from you. Your STY community will be here for you forever, to support you, to be proud of you, to grow with you as you move through the world as the powerful, caring human beings you are. The world is counting on you. It will be difficult. You can do difficult things. Congratulations and good luck, my wonderful and special first class ever, class of 2020. I am so proud of you.
Now get ready to hear from one of two incredible keynote speakers. First up, Telly Leung, a Stuyvesant alum who has graced Broadway from Rent to Aladdin. Take it away, Mr. Leung.
Hi, I'm Telly Leung. I am a Broadway actor, and I am also a Stuyvesant grad. I was in the class of 1998. That was 22 years ago. You guys weren't even born yet. It was a really long time ago. And I am honored and thrilled that I can be part of your graduation ceremony. Now, I am not thrilled that we are meeting under these circumstances, and there's no sugarcoating it. This sucks. And I know that you are all feeling the disappointment of missing out on so many of those things that you were looking forward to about senior year, whether it's senior sing or prom or graduation. I was actually thinking about you guys a couple of weeks ago. I was taking a bike ride downtown, and bike rides have been really good for me during this quarantine. It's a way for me to get fresh air. It's a way for me to clear my head. And I passed by Sty, and I was flooded with all of these visceral memories of my time there in that building. And yes, I thought about my graduation, and yes, I thought about sing and prom, but I also thought about all the little moments about being a Stuyvesant student, about walking across that bridge every morning half asleep, about rehearsing late at night at the Murray Kahn Theater. I thought about conversations that I had with my friends just sitting in the hallways by the lockers. And I'm here to tell you that those memories don't go away. No virus can ever take those memories away from you. They are forever. And the connections that you've made with your classmates, they are forever. It's been 22 years, and I'm still close to several of my classmates from the class of 1998. In 2008, I was part of the final company of Rent on Broadway. Now, Rent was a really big deal when I was in high school. Everybody was obsessed with Rent. It came out in 1996. I remember being a junior and cutting class to go to J&R Music World downtown, which was a big CD store right near City Hall. And I remember lining up and the line being wrapped around the block to get the double disc CD original Broadway cast recording of Rent. I always think of my high school experience when I hear songs from Rent. And so I wanted to share just a couple of songs with you today. As we live in these unprecedented times, I think it's important to just take it one day at a time. Moments so dear. 25,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles, in laughter, in strife, in 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year in the life? How about class of 2020. Be well, be safe.
Thank you so much for those words of wisdom and those beautiful songs.
And now for Billy Eichner, also a Stuyvesant alum. You might recognize him from Parks and Rec or Billy on the Street. He's a producer, he's an actor, and he's also a comedian.
Hey everyone, it's Billy Eichner. And I know people are used to me screaming at them on the street, but I'm inside today, as all of us are, and I'm sorry we can't be there together in person, but as a Stuyvesant alumni myself, alumni, I'm not that smart, even though I went to Stuyvesant. As you know, some people at Stuyvesant aren't that smart, as it turns out. Anyway, I want to say congratulations to all the graduates. I truly am sorry that we can't be there together, but I went to Stuyvesant, graduated a long time ago, so I can't speak to how it is to go to Stuyvesant right now. I'm sure some things are similar, and I'm sure some things are very different as the world has changed so much and continues to change. I just wanted to let you know that one thing I realized when I left Stuy is that Stuyvesant, although it's a very privileged place to be, and it's a great privilege to be able to go there, as I'm sure you all know, you have enormous resources and access, you're around very hardworking, intelligent people who are all striving really hard to get ahead, and there's a lot to be said for it. Some great teachers, a beautiful building, you get to go to high school in the greatest city in the world, New York City. And there's a lot to be said for it. But what I realized when I left is that, you know, I had worked so hard at Stuyvesant. It's very demanding. It's a very uniquely demanding school. And I know how hard it is to get through Stuyvesant, that although it's a great privilege, it's also very, very challenging. And I had friends there who would kick themselves if they got a 96 on a test instead of a perfect score. I had friends who would kick themselves if they got a 1200 on the SATs instead of a 1600 on the SATs. And I have a feeling some of that is still going on. And I want to let you know that I understand how challenging that can be and how hard on yourself you may have been. And I just want to say congratulations, because whether you were a person who got a perfect score on every test or a person who messed up and didn't get a perfect score sometimes, or whether maybe you were a person that just said, screw it, I don't care about school, even though I'm at Stuyvesant, which I have respect for that too in some ways. Sorry, teachers. But I just wanna say I am so proud of you, and that you have made it through a very unique and challenging and demanding high school experience. When I got to college, I went to Northwestern, a very good school, also a place of great privilege. But a lot of the kids I spoke to there had not had to work nearly as hard as I had to work in high school. And then we ended up in the same place, which for a little while pissed me off. Because I was like, I went to Stuyvesant, I had to kill myself to get here. Which was frustrating in certain ways, but also I was proud of myself because I had committed and I had worked so hard. And college for me ended up being one of the greatest experiences of my life. But Stuyvesant was also a great experience. My best friend to this day, basically like my brother, is a friend I made at Stuyvesant. we came out to each other right after we graduated. That's a whole other story. I'll save that for another time. But, you know, a very meaningful person in my life. And that goes back to my Stuyvesant days. It's the first place I started to write comedy and perform comedy and even figure out that I was a comedy writer and that I had a certain strength in that area. Even though it was a math science school, I was always very bad at the math science stuff. And I still don't know how I got into Stuyvesant or why they're letting me even give you this speech right now. But I know how challenging it can be, and I'm really proud of you. And also want to let you know from personal experience that all that stuff in calculus, that it gave me such a headache. It was so stressful for me when I was there, all that math and science stuff I wasn't particularly good at. I never needed it again. Never again. So just if you were like me and you weren't good at those things, just know that it's fine. You'll really never need them. But if you were good, good for you. Congratulations. I hope to get to do this in person one day. Stay safe, stay healthy, keep protesting, stay vigilant, stay loud, stay passionate, and have fun in college, because it's fun.
Thank you so much, Billy. Now let's hear from Vishwa Sofot, our student union president.
Good afternoon, faculty and staff, administrators, parents and loved ones, and above all, class 2020. My name is Vishwa Sofot, and it is my honor to address you as your Stuyvesant Student Union President. I've been thinking about this speech and what I would say if I became SU President since we were freshmen. I would describe the happy moments and the small things that irked me about Stuy and put them into a speech that I proudly gave to a large audience of me, myself, and I in the shower. But when it came time to craft this speech, my final message to all of you, those rehearsals didn't quite help. I felt lost. I wound up at Stuy by sheer circumstance. My family was visiting New York for a brief 2-week trip that turned into a permanent relocation due to my father's health. I took the summer SHSAT, and only 2 weeks before high school started, I discovered that I would be attending Stuyvesant. I came in to plan out my schedule a couple of days before the first day of school, and even with the pre-Talos era programming office, I was incorrectly put into French 2. Mr. Ramirez can attest that did not work out too well. As I think back to that first day, I remember the fear and the uncertainty. I remember entering from the first floor entrance, not knowing what the Tribeca Bridge was, only to be scolded by the security guards. I remember not knowing what to expect. The 10 floors of 345 Chamber Street feel intimidating. The presence of so many smart people feels daunting. The passion to learn and grow can be seen in hallways full of students buried in their books, in the atriums after school as dance and sports teams practice, or in any of the many courses we have all had to take thanks to the never-ending requirements of the Stuyvesant diploma. Seriously, what would we all do without drafting? The energy of Stuyvesant drew me in and kept me in the building until 6 or 7 p.m., far more often than I probably should have. But as I walked the hallways, dapping up people, waving across the hall, and stopping to quickly catch up with friends before running off to class, the smile on my face and the warmth aside reminded me of what I love most about Stuyvesant, and that is each and every one of you. You all accepted me and provided me the opportunity to learn and grow, especially as a leader. It has been an honor and a privilege to have represented you as an elected official for the last 4 years. Your support energized my will to fight for and represent the student voice, even when it meant being pitted against the whole PE department in an attempt to get PSAL freeze. Pro tip, don't call physical education gym. From Vision Believe to Vision, Caucus to Student Union, I've cherished every moment representing you, the class of 2020, and Stuyvesant. Thank you for being a part of this journey, especially to my SU folks. I can't imagine a high school experience without you all. As a grade, we have set new traditions. As a school, we have redefined our values. We have certainly come a long way from broken escalators. Wait, never mind. There's a lot more work to be done. These last 4 years, I've noticed that our community can often be apathetic. We have low voter turnouts and uncontested elections. We complain and complain, but make little effort to address the issues that affect so many of us. We turn a blind eye to things we know are wrong. As citizens of Stuyvesant, our apathy allows for a culture that fosters both an unhealthy and competitive environment, but also an unwelcoming space for many students, especially our Black, Latino, and female peers. We look past microaggressions and broken policies because it's convenient for us. I ask of you all to stand up for yourselves and for those around you. Your voice can uplift others and bring attention to issues that have long been ignored. As famous screenwriter Aaron Sorkin said, decisions are made by those who show up. Don't ever forget that you're a citizen of this world. Don't ever forget that you're a citizen of this world, and there are things you can do to lift the human spirit. Things that are easy, things that are free, things that you can do every day. Civility, respect, kindness, character. Don't ever forget that a small group of thoughtful people can change the world. It's the only thing that ever has. We're no small group of thoughtful people. There are 857 of us. So our collective potential to impact the world is tremendous. I'm optimistic to see us seek change within Stuyvesant and address the inequities of society as alumni. Before I end, I'd like to say a few quick thank yous. Thank you to Mr. Contreras for being a mentor, a friend, and the best friends book I've ever asked for. Thank you to Mr. Plotzo for making me a more open thinker and a strong leader. Thank you to Dr. Greenwald for pushing me to be a better student and for her goats and candy whenever I was sleeping in class. Thank you to Ms. Guthrie for her overwhelming support and guidance that got me through STI. Thank you to my parents for being there for me at all times, including this speech right now, dealing with my frustrated, grumpy self, always pushing me to do more and be better, and for sacrificing so much for me and my aspirations. Thank you to all of you, teachers, administrators, and peers, once again, for making Stuyvesant my second home. Hasta luego. Until next time, class 2020. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishwa. Now let's hear from our salutatorian, Jackie Lynn.
Hey everyone, my name is Jackie Lynn, and yes, we went to high school together. I'll be speaking to you as your salutatorian today. It is still crazy to me how big the school actually is. Only at Stuyvesant will you still meet a senior you've never seen before in June. And when I first stepped up to those four doors on a bridge, two of which don't open by the way, I remember thinking that I was going to be in for a wild ride. And I was right. On the first day of school, I asked to go to the bathroom at the beginning of class. I didn't want to take too long, so I rushed out without drying my hands. So I'm in the hallway, shaking my hands to dry them, and the water from my hands landed right in front of my feet, and I slipped. There was an English teacher who saw, and she was like, "Oh my God, are you okay? Who spilled this water here? Oh my, this is outrageous. I have to call the custodian." And the whole time, I was just standing there mortified. That pretty much sums up my 4 years at STI. I slipped on my own hand water again and again and again. It got pretty rough sometimes, I'm not gonna lie. There were times when I would drink coffee second period and be knocked out third period. Or when I had four tests in one day and I only studied for 2.5. Or, God forbid, walking into a bathroom during fifth period and finding that it was already clean out of toilet paper. But the question that I get the most often is, do I regret it? I honestly don't know what my life would have looked like if I went somewhere else. I don't know what might have been, what could have been. But what I do know is that I would have never been able to learn about the fiascos of AP European history or annotate all 58 pages of Common Sense. There were so many chances that I took here. Whether it was taking a class I thought I wouldn't like or talking to someone new that I am so glad I took, because it brought me new friends, new passions, and let me discover something new about myself. So no, I don't regret any of it. I don't regret taking a chance on STI. Because in the end, it's always been STI who took a chance on me. The handball team who took a chance on a girl who hit people with the ball more than she hit the wall. The speech team who took a chance on a girl who hadn't quite found her voice yet. And all of you took a chance on a small girl from Brooklyn who slips on her own hand water. So thank you. Thank you to Ms. Pohan, who I've known since her flip phone days. Thank you to Mr. Coco for all his manganese calc awesomeness. Thank you to Dr. O'Malley and Ms. Pluccino for being the coolest and the tallest chemistry duo ever. And thank you to all the countless teachers and friends who have been there for me and who I could not possibly all shout out in a 5-minute speech. I have been so lucky. So lucky to have met the kindest, smartest, and most talented bunch of people ever. To have people that make saying goodbye so hard. Up until something ends, you never realize it's ending. Hindsight really is, I guess you could say, 2020. And I know that it sucks that our senior year has been cut short. There are so many regrets, so many people we never got to properly say goodbye to. I still have a box of Cheez-Its in my locker. But hey, we had some pretty great moments. We organized a climate protest, and we put on an unforgettable sing show. We have a brand new 3-to-5 escalator, and coffee is finally allowed in school. Even in the face of a global pandemic, the Stuyvesant community has remained strong. Whether it's finding ways to keep Spirit Days going, or uniting to fight racial inequality. Our talents and unique capabilities have brought us together. And I know that it will take each and every one of us far. Graduation is not the end. It is only the beginning. And I hope that everyone here will blaze their own paths and leave the earth shaking where they trod. Keep fighting for what you believe in and take lots of chances. Stuyvesant High School, class of 2020, give them hell. Congratulations, everyone.
Thank you for your wisdom, Jackie. Up next is Victoria Wong, our valedictorian. Let's have her take it away.
Hi, everyone. I'm Victoria Wong, and I'm so honored to be this year's valedictorian. Before anything else, I just wanted to say a huge congratulations to the class of 2020. I still find it kind of crazy that we're graduating, but we've actually made it. So I'd like to start off by thanking a ton of people. First, a big thank you to Zainab, Hannah, Mr. Palazzo, and anyone else who's been working to give us this virtual graduation. Thank you so much for trying to give us the best send-off possible. Next, I really want to thank my family, to my parents who came here from China and have been working tirelessly ever since, to my grandma who always slides plates of cut fruit onto my desk whenever I'm working, to my brother and sister-in-law, the coolest chefs, board game experts, and new parents in town, and to the rest of my cousins, aunts, and uncles. I feel so lucky and grateful to have you all by my side. I also want to thank all the teachers that I've had or worked with at STY, whether I was in your class for a single semester or for all 4 years, or if I've worked with you on an extracurricular, it's truly always been a pleasure. And along with you, thank you to our principal, Mr. Contreras, our assistant principals and deans, our wonderful counselors, our security guards and cafeteria workers, and every single member of the faculty that's been keeping STY up and running these past 4 years. Now, before I say my last thank you, I just wanted to tell a quick story about my junior year. Like a lot of people, I'm sure, junior year was really stressful for me. It definitely wasn't easy balancing harder classes and exams and extracurriculars, but on top of that, in the beginning of my junior year, I also found out about the death of a close friend of mine. And for months afterward, I felt grief and guilt and regret, but mainly, I felt like the world had betrayed or lied to me somehow. Before then, I was naive, and after, I was disillusioned. But as the year went on, I leaned on those around me, and I found guidance in things I came across in my classes and clubs. And in the end, I came out of junior year with a clear approach of how I want to live my life. Thinking that the world is a good place is a blissfully ignorant way to live, while knowing instead that the world isn't entirely a good place, and yet still believing that one day it can and will be is much harder. But that second option is how I want to live my life. And to my fellow graduates, I hope that's how you'll do so as well. But the key word here is want, because inevitably there will be days or weeks or months when it'll just be impossible to believe that the world can actually be a good place. But in those moments, you can still act as if you believe it, by looking for the good in people and situations, or creating good where you don't see enough or any. And on an occasion like graduation, there's good to be found in the past, present, and future. For the past, rather than thinking about the things you missed out on this year, think of the good memories you've made. For me, what comes to mind is the epic senior sing that we put on, and playing games during our last Big Sib homeroom picnics, and laying my head down on my friends' laps in the senior atrium to the sounds of our grade talking and laughing and playing guitar. I'm sure you guys have good moments of your own from STAT in these past 4 years, so today, think of those. For the present, of course, appreciate the good in the people and things that you have in your life, but also appreciate the good in yourself, which I know some of you don't do nearly as often or as much as you should. By graduating from STI, some of us are already achieving more than our parents could have ever imagined, and most of us have probably gone through some sort of hardship. So whether it was mental, physical, or external, give yourself some credit for getting through it, or for mustering up the strength to go through it right now. Some of us are talented artists, some of us are strong athletes, but not me. Some of us are crazy smart scientists, and some of us are even more. So today, think of one good adjective to describe yourself, and then another, and then one more, and keep going until you feel proud of yourself. Finally, for the future, seeking out and creating good has never been more relevant in our lifetimes than right now, because climate change is still a very real issue. Our country's politics are failing too many of us. COVID-19 and its effects won't be going away for some time. And it's scary just how many people and institutions still don't get that Black lives don't just matter, but they need to be cherished and protected. Unfortunately, the list goes on and on, but that just means that there are so many avenues we can choose to do some good for the world, which will only ever be as good as the people living in it. Now for my final thank you, which you can all probably guess by now, but I'm gonna say anyway. My final thank you goes to STI's class of 2020. Some of you are my best friends, some of you are my good friends, some of you are just acquaintances or names to me, and some of you have never had the chance to meet, which might make you suspect that my thanks are insincere, but I truly do thank everyone in our class for being on this ride with me for the past 4 years, for the memories we share if I was lucky enough to create any with you, or if not, for just being the unique people behind the faces that are seen in the halls. I didn't know I would miss that so much, but I really do. And at the very least, thank you for listening to this speech. So with all of that being said, congratulations once more. I hope you all live your lives trying to believe in the good, and let's meet again one day.
Well, I guess it's just us now, Hannah.
I guess it is.
Well then, let's see your speech.
Good afternoon, seniors. I am Hannah Kim, and I am speaking to you today as one of your class co-presidents. The first line I ever read at STI went something like this. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. This is the opening line of A Tale of Two Cities, and it's a line that has stuck with me for the past 4 years because I think it quite embodies the Stuyvesant experience. It was the best of times. We are so, so blessed to have been taught in a school full of teachers and faculty that are not only passionate and knowledgeable, but that care so deeply for their students. Sure, they made us cry sometimes, many times, with their devastating tests and backbreaking workloads, but it was through them that we learned to love and love to learn. Our school is also in such a dynamic, beautiful location. There is nothing quite like strolling by the Hudson River at night, picnicking in Battery Park on warm afternoons, or walking to Chinatown in search of a treat, all with their friends, of course. For STI, and especially the best parts of it, are defined by the people we met here. The students at STI are quite unlike anything else. Within STI's 10 floors, I have watched my classmates fill every inch of it with their intellect, passion, and kindness. From long nights spent practicing for same performances, to all those collaborative study guides made so that everyone could pass that test, the class of 2020 has shown me that there is no need to sacrifice heart for ambition. Now to address the latter half of the statement. It was the worst of times. A STI student hasn't had some choice words. From accidentally spilling her coffee while trying to sneak it in, to surviving the academic pressure cooker that this school is, Stuyvesant can be a lot. Honestly, it's a lot of work. We often woke up before the sun even rose, staggering out of our beds onto the late trains to make our way to Chambers Street. And on top of all those all-nighters and the natural high school drama, we've had to live through a terror attack, gas scares, and now a pandemic. In the end though, when I think back on Psy, I don't remember any of the math tests I failed, nor those days where I had to scale 7 flights of stairs for a class. No matter how many times I have claimed to be excited to be finally free of Psy, I have never truly meant it. This school is a haven for children. Children who are full of passion, who are still unsure of themselves, and who have so much potential yet to be realized. It's a time and place where we can grow boundlessly, and if there's something I'm scared of, it's a time when most of the people around me, including myself, love hardened into adults. This is the note I want to end on, to ask the class of 2020 to stay children for just a little longer, because it's this quality of Psy that made it so special. It's easy to focus on all of the bad that has happened at Psy. Like children, we bickered, and like children, we hurt one another. But above everything, it was our ability to dream vividly, unabashedly, and childishly that I will remember the most. At graduation, this might seem a little silly and a little late to say. Surely it was the best of times, and surely it was the worst of times. But for all the good and bad that has happened these past 4 years, this is my biggest wish: to let the time called Stuyvesant High School linger for just a moment longer. Thank you to my parents, to all of my teachers and staff, to all of my friends, and to you, class of 2020, for making my Psy experience the wonderful thing it was.
Last but certainly least, let's have you finish it up, Zainab.
Hello, Stuyvesant class of 2020. My name is Zainab Bromberg, and I am reporting live from Carnegie Hall as one of your class co-presidents. Just kidding, I'm actually at home in Brooklyn. I so badly wish I could be with all of you right now. Hopefully you are all safe and healthy and still get to experience this virtual graduation ceremony with your loved ones. In many ways, we left Psy 3 months ago. This graduation feels almost delayed, and with each passing day, it becomes harder and harder to remember the tiny magical moments that brighten the hallways of 345 Chambers Street. Sometimes, when I'm really missing my friends, I'll close my eyes and try to relive those memories. I remember bawling as the curtains closed on our last showing of Senior Sing. I remember hugging my friends tightly as we rushed off the stage, settling into the knowledge that this would be our last Sing, and unbeknownst to us at the time, our last Stuyvesant performance. I remember how exciting it felt when the guys at Fairies first memorized my order. Quattro special, right? They asked before I even walked all the way up to the display case. Nodding vigorously with a huge smile on my face, I felt right at home. I remember staying up late on calls with Hannah, trying to navigate Excel spreadsheets and virtual graduation software, frustrated by how our senior year was ending, but still endlessly thankful for being part of a student union that works so hard to give back to its community. It's near impossible to resist the ephemerality of high school memories. Hold on to them tightly. Absorb every single detail about the people and places that make you feel happy and loved. Take note of the sights, scents, smells, sounds, and feelings that characterize these moments so that you can recall them within the blink of an eye. In Colson Whitehead's Colossus of New York, he describes the city as 8 million naked cities in one naked city, an amalgamation of each individual New Yorker's own perception. Stuyvesant fits that analogy perfectly. My Psy was probably not your Psy. Maybe our Psys overlapped, perhaps by way of Dr. Tu's biology class freshman year or APUSH with Mr. Grease. Maybe you and I were both in Mr. Sandler's classroom on the second floor on October 31st, 2018, when 8 people were killed and 11 injured in a terrorist attack along the West Side Highway. Maybe, like me, you ate lunch in the SU room every day and it holds a special place in your heart. On the other hand, it's just as likely that you never even entered the SU room. As much as I am thankful for the universal Stuyvesant experiences that bring us all together, I'm even more grateful for getting to learn about the vastly different individual 4,000 naked cities that each of my classmates experience. Stuyvesant has pushed me to explore my city and the multitude of experiences of its inhabitants. Stuyvesant students teach and inspire me every single day. And yet, as diverse and amazing as our community can be, we are also all relatively privileged in shelters, some more than others. The quality of education that we receive is truly outstanding. From the very first moment we walk across Tribeca Bridge, we are handed access to incredible resources, an enthusiastic college office, an extensive alumni network, the list goes on. It is our responsibility as Stuyvesant students, and now alumni, to hold on to the special memories that build each of our respective high school experiences. But more importantly, it is crucial that we move on from this momentous time in our lives with the understanding and appreciation of the values of other experiences, especially ones we are not quite familiar with. We all have the tools to educate ourselves. Equipped with these tools, it is now time for us to discover and amplify the voices of those less heard. It's been a true honor serving as your caucus president. Thank you for trusting me with this job and making me proud to represent our class. Thank you to my teachers for pushing me to explore my intellectual curiosity, and of course, thank you to my mom and dad and brother Bora for having my back every step of the way. As the cast of Senior Sing sang in our finale song, now we're ready to go, and we want the world to know, bring it on, bring it on, bring it on. Bring it on, Sty, you are all in my heart forever and always.
Thank you so much for joining us in our virtual graduation ceremony.
Also, big, big thank you to Mr. Palazzo for being with us every step of the often confusing way.
Thank you, Hannah, for being the best co-pres ever.
Thank you, Zainab Bromberg, for being the peanut butter to my jelly. It has been one wild ride, but I would not have done it with anyone else.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Mohidul Abedin. Sharia Abid. Amal Ahmad. Tamjid Ahmed. Wasik Ahmed. Zunayed Ahmed. Shakib Alam. Omar Ali. Ahem El Nasser. Ryan Alwi. Julia Amoroso. Lucas Amory. Tasneem Emran. Albina Ananian. Harper Andrews.
Thank you to everyone who made Sty special and brought a little fun and happiness into my days there.
Ariel Einey. Tasneem Anika. Alexander Annenberg. Lee Appel. Rayhan Arafin. Urjan Arya. Chloe Au. Elizabeth Abakov. Benjamin Avrahami. Shahariar Azad. Alvi Aziz. Cecilia Bacana. Samson Badlia. Christian Bay. Sheng Bai. Claire Bartholomew. Sarah Isabel Bautista, Julian Bedelis, Elias Bernstein, Rishi Bhatt, Proga Buyan, Sma Saad, Maxim Blachirov, Chris Boodrum, Julia Brestovitskia.
I would like to thank my family and friends for supporting and motivating me throughout my educational career. Through these challenging times, our years become even stronger, and I have no doubt that all of us will go on to achieve personal success. Go Peg Legs!
Samuel Brink, Zeynep Bromberg.
Congratulations, guys.
Christopher Brown, Leon Bowie, Alan Bunyatov, Lydia Burke, Kevin Tsai, Oliver Kai, Alexander Kameyev, Tiffany Cow, William Cow, Sin Chi Cow, Viola Casper Schulte, Brandy Chan, Clement Chan, Garby Chan, Jocelyn Chan, Casey Chan, Kenny Chan, Matthew Chan, William Chan, Divya Chanani, Shreyantan Chanda, Caitlin Chow, Emily Chow, Martin Chapman, Angelique Charles Davis.
Hey guys, I'm so, so proud of our grade for graduating, and I miss you all so, so much. Best of luck in the future.
Adam Chen, Amanda Chen, Annie Chen, Anise Chen, Brandon Chen, Connie Chen, Doris Chen, Eric Chen, Eric Chen, Erica Chen, Ethan Chen. Hong Wei Chen. Irene Chen. Jackie Chen. Jason Chen. Jeffrey Chen. Jem Chen. Jesse Chen. Jing Ying Chen. Justin Chen. Justin Chen. Kelly Chen. Kevin Chen. Ling Chen. Mark Chen. Marvin Chen. Michael Chen. Mike Chen. Michelle Chen. Phil Chen. Roy Chen. Royan Chen. Sherry Chen. Stephanie Chen. Tammy Chen. Thomas Chen. Tianshang Chen. Tina Chen. Vanessa Chen. Vela Chen. Brian Chang. Kei Chang. Alisa Chung. Rachel Chung. Kenneth Chin. Thomas Chin. Christopher Cho.
To my friends and family, thank you for making my last 4 years at STI such a wonderful experience. I really couldn't have made it without you, so thank you.
Dahe Choi. Gloria Choi. Min Young Choi. Yasul Choi. Nuzat Choudhury. Biraj Choudhury. Dewan Choudhury. Angelina Chu. Calvin Chu. Christy Chu. Lai Hua Chu. James Chun. Alvin Chung. Yun J. Chung. Cosmo Cohen. Adam Cohen. Rebecca Collins. Nathan Cooper Cook. Thomas Creighton. Kinu Dadayil. Colin Dan. Ethan Danilov. Sydney Dow. Soman Dar. Akash Das. Zoe Davis. Mark DePaula. Anupama Debnath. Tenzin Dechen. Michael Dektiar. Sebastian DeLong. Hao Dong Deng. Zi Tang Diao. Adrian Dixon. Lucas Dingman. Laurent Doan. Catherine Dodson. George Dong. Jackie Dong. Ricky Dong. Oscar Dorr. Elizabeth Doss. Shama Dutta. Gordon Ebanks. Cecilia Ehrlichman. Jane Echtman. Tanzim Ilahi. Mohammed Elish. Abdullah El Kadrai. Mahmoud El Sharawi. Oscar Eng. Eric Diana Ehrenberg. Rubaiyat E. Alam Ithika. Kayla Fang. Samuel Fang. Faria Farah. Lena Farley. Omar Farouk. Aflaha Fatiha. Kiyan Fawaz. Beverly Fang. Patrick Fennessy. Elias Ferguson. Dorothy Fong. Vincent Fong. Amy Fosia. Abdullah Foysel. Hannah Ian Freed. Flora Weirawan Fu. Ivan Galikov. John Gao. Star Cecily Garcia. Alexander Gattegno. Thomas Gita. Mia Gindis. Bryant Goh. David Goldstein. Anna Grace Goldstein.
Congratulations, guys. Thank you for being the best class and the best friends imaginable. And thanks everyone who fought with me or worked with me or created with me along the way. You guys are the best.
Max Goldstein. Daniel Gomez. Yevgenia Gorbachev.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Daniel Gorelick.
It's been 4 years, quite a trip. I think I've grown as a person, had a lot of new experiences. It's all over now, and really interested in seeing what comes next.
Camilla Green.
My name's Camilla. And you're watching me graduate.
Noah Greenstein. Chen Ji Gu. Christy Guan. Andrew Guo. Raymond Guo. Hafsa Habib. Theodore Hagel. Madison Hafner. Aditya Heyman. Amy Halder. Debesh Halder. Jesse Hall.
Well, that was quite a ride. I had fun. Did you? I know I sure did.
Claire Hahn. Kevin Hahn. Stella Hahn. Lele Howe.
Congrats to the class of 2020 and good luck in the future. You guys are some of the most inspiring, talented, and dedicated people that I've ever met.
Shireen Hawk. Julia Hart. Marab Hassan. Tashfia Hassan. Michael Hayes Morrow. Wei He. Presley Hernandez. Morgan Hesse. Andrew Hurdle. Tiffany Ho. Mima Hawk. Mohammed Hawk. Zamir Hawk. Ibtada Hossein. Andrew Hu. Susanna Hu. Amy Huang. Angel Huang. Annie Huang. Chloe Huang. Eric Huang. Karen Huang. Liana Huang. Matthew Huang. Megan Huang. Peihua Huang. Kwang Jo Huang. Ruby Huang. Tyler Huang. Vincent Huang. Wilson Huang. Ahmed Hussein. Vivian Huyn. Austin Huang. Yuna Huang. Tasneem Ibnat. Ahmed Ibtida. Artem Ilyanuk. Sabia Imran. Zorais Irshad.
It's been an eventful 4 years, and now we're finally graduating. Thank you to all my friends and family for your support, and best of luck in the future.
Kaylee Ishikawa. Aryan Islam. Mir Islam. Mohammed Islam. Mohammed Islam. Muzahidul Islam. Raisa Islam. Ryan Islam. Ifat Itu. Mina Ivkovich. Connor Jackson. Kazi Jamal. Darius Jankowskis. Ibnat Jihan. Georgina Jenkins. Nina Jennings.
Congrats 2020. Thanks for making this place so hard to leave.
Tamid Jewell. Meng Yao Jia.
I would like to thank my friends and teachers for making high school an amazing 4 years. I will truly miss everyone.
Angela Jiang. Anthony Jiang. Jamie Jiang. Kai Jiang. Tina Jang. Vivian Jiang. William Jang. Darren Jin. Lily Jin. Ariam Joe. Serene Joe. Amani Johnson. Baird Johnson. Javed Jokai. Nicholas June. Eric Jung. Allison Jaray. Celine Caney. Caleb Kahan. Jordan Keisman. Leonidas Kalpaxis. Nathan Kahn. Joanne Kang. Benjamin Kaplan. Omar Kostrat. Yoshiaki Kato. Arian Kayum. Stephen K. Irtisam Ka. Afam Khan. Clarice Khan. Faharyar Khan. Farhana Khan. Fozia Khan. Janine Khan. Mohammed Ahmed Khan. Nafel Khan. Nahi Khan. Samanto Khan. Sudat Khan. Ilona Kimmy, Dilbar Hojimuratova, Annabelle Kim, Christopher Kim, Christopher Kim, Emily Kim, Hannah Ruby Kim, Jessica Kim, Min Kim, Minook Kim, Richard Kim, Taejoon Kim, Yeun Kim, Hiro Kimura, Rachel Kodish, Jonas Kong, Shan Mei Kong, Stavroula Kostas, Henry Kotkin, Veronica Kowalski.
We did it, guys. We made history. Congratulations to all the graduates of 2020 and the wonderful teachers who made it happen.
Michael Kozlov, Marko Krstulovic, Nancy Kwong, Victor Kwong, Galathara Kumari, Leo Kwok, Iram Labib, Aixa LaCroix, Brian Lai, Nora Lai, Baraka Lam, Clara Lam, Eric Lam, Jack Lam, Jason Lam, Jennifer Lam, Justin Lam.
Hi there, class of 2020. Congrats to everyone who made it this far, and stay bold, everyone.
Justin Lam, Vanessa Lam, Winnie Lam, Derek Lau.
Class of 2020, congratulations. I hope to see you guys again in the future, and good luck on all your endeavors.
Eric Lau, Caitlin Lau, Po Yuen Lau, Jessica Rosalia Lazis, Ada Lee. Benjamin Lee. Chong Lee. Derek Lee. Emma Lee. Jeremy Lee. Joseph Lee. Junhee Lee. Justin Lee. Lydia Lee. Marianne Lee. Raymond Lee. Sonia Lee. Stephen Lee. Victoria Lee. Yejun Lee. Yang Ho Lee. Yuna Lee. Jun Tao Lei. Samantha Lei. Su Liang Lei. Alexander Leong. Rachel Leong. Erica Lerman. Anthony Leung. Derek Leung.
We made it, yo. 4 years. It's been real. Keep doing what you're doing. Got this.
Sarah Leung. Sylvester Layton. Alex Lee. Andy Lee. Anna Lee. Anthony Lee. Baron Lee. Benson Lee. Brian Lee. Calvin Lee. Endar Lee. Evan Lee. Francis Lee. Franklin Lee. Kevin Lee. Michelle Lee. Tiffany Lee. Tiffany Lee. Vanessa Lee. Victor Lee. Zhu Wei Lee. Christina Leanne. Emma Leanne. Kevin Liang. Acero Liang Lee. Tasman Libson. Ada Lin. Aliciana Lin. Chun Bin Lin. Crystal Lin. Daniel Lin. Devin Lin. Eric Lin. Ivan Lin. Jackie Lin. Jason Lin. Jeff Lin. Jerry Lin. Jia Yang Lin. Jing Yen Lin. Joey Lin. Jonathan Lin. Junao Lin. Karen Lin. Kevin Lin. Ki-ing Lin. Leanne Kai Lin. Marvin Lin. Michael Lin. Sammy Lin. Sandy Lin. Tyrone Lin. Vincent Lin. Vincent Lin. Wen Tao Lin. William Lin. Xiao Tong Alex Lin. Yifei Lin. Yin Yi Lin. Yuan Quan Lin. Emma Linderman. Franklin Leo. Barry Liu. Henry Liu. Henry Liu. Kelly Liu. Kevin Liu. Gui Jing Liu. Stephanie Liu. Timmy Liu. Victor Liu. Zihan Liu. Brendan Lowe. Darren Lowe. Jade Lowe. Eleanor Loprest. Kevin Liu. Vivian Liu. Shi Liu. Aaron Lubelski. Tiffany Liu. Eric Lung. Jimmy Luo. Kevin Liu. Yaru Lua. David Lupia. Catherine Nguyen. Garrett Lee. Bradley Ma. Lenny Ma. David Madrigal. Caroline Magok. Maximilian Ma.
Lots of love to my parents, my extended family, baseball coaches, the music department, counselors, faculty, friends, and anybody else that I may be forgetting who helped me on my Stuyvesant journey.
Tahseen Mahmood. Nabil Mahmood. Cindy Mai.
Hi, this is Cindy, and I want to thank my family, my friends, my teachers, and all faculty members for supporting me for the last 4 years. Congratulations, class of 2020!
Susan Mai. Ayan Majumder. Leon Maxson.
Hi, I'm Leon, and I'd like to thank Stuy and every friend, teacher, and classmate who shaped me to be who I am today and for showing me that the sky, quite literally, is never the limit.
Maranissa Malik. Saida Maliha. Zaid Malik. Stefan Manifov. Grace Mao.
Hey guys, we finally made it. Thanks to my family, my friends, and all of you for helping me get here. Class of 2020, we're graduates now!
Chrissy Marr. Tara Mavenicare. Esther May. Fiona May. Yingzi May. Zihao Mei.
Happy graduation, lads. Hope the 4 years were worth it.
Kevin Mesta. Maisha Mia. Jonathan Min Tut. Sergei Mishchenko. Masataka Mizuno. Natasha Moslinger. Tony Moe. Dia Jolie Mohan. Farhan Mola. Jeremy Mahler. Jayati Mandal. Brian Monhe Serrano.
I'd like to thank everyone who has helped me throughout my high school career, who was able to help push me to be more motivated and find the things that I love.
Jung Yan Moon. Ethan Morgan. Brian Moses. Lillian Moy. Nicole Mui. Sarah Mui. Sophia Mui. Tysine Murad. CeeLo Murphy. Kuram Mustafa. Eugene Nam. Julie Nam. Teresa Nam. Han Nam Gung. Tejas Narayan. Priscilla Nadawijaya. Tareem Nawaz. Andrew Ng. Kelvin Ng. Lim Jo Ng. Ricky Ng. Trevor Ng. Corbin I. Jackson No. Susan Nguyen. Alice Nee. Denchi Nee. Sophie Nickel. Mihrab Niloy. Cheryl C. Nadi. Alexandra Nobert.
Act one done.
Cheyenne Nomani. Philip Novgorodsky. Tashi Naima. Loretta Uy. Connor O. Sangha O. Jacob Olin. Alex Oltenew. Angelina Lee. 6 Asibur Pubin. Megan Pan. Amy Park. Ashley Park. Emma Park. Joseph Park. Leia Park.
Hello, Stuyvesant High School. Happy 2020 graduation.
William Park. Shreya Paul. Lauren Pelavanian. Dechen Pema. Amanda Peng. Stanley Peng. Timothy Peng. Winston Peng. Julia Pepper. Corinne Pita.
Thank you to everyone who supported me these past 4 years. And to my classmates, remember, there's always a reason to smile. Go 2020!
Talia Pomeroy.
Thank you to my friends and family for all your love and support.
Brian Poon. Christopher Poon. Owen Potter.
Go for it.
Lena Povolotskia. Natan Premost. Alyssa Pustilnik. Emily Piatkovsky. Amanda Quinn. David Chu. Delia Q. Yilin Chu. Ivan Q. Mael Quentin. Stephanie Quiros. Aman Qureshi. Fahim Rahman.
Thank you, everyone that was there for me when things got rough throughout the years, but I hope I can make you guys proud when I finally get to study art and design.
Modadur Rahman. Saida Rahman. Tasfia Rahman. Umana Rahman. Arjun Rai. Paul Ramnauth. Rebecca Ramsamy. Rita Rana. Mahmoodal Rapi. Pratham Rawat. Stephanie Raza. Anais Rael. Elizabeth Reyes. Sharon Wren. Kandikar Ridwan. Jude Rizzo. Michael Robertson. Isabella Rocha. Sam Rosenstrouch.
Thank you to all my friends and family who've supported me during my time at STEI. You guys are the most resilient group of peers I've ever met. Bye, class of 2020.
Rohit Roy. Thibaut Roy. Erica Ruan. Emily Rubenstein. Kyle Sachs. Camille Sadoff. Debasri Saha. Minhajul Saim. Adnan Sarkar. Luis Enrique Sauce. Morgan Seberg. Eugene Seo. Min Jun Su. Elizabeth Sham. Eric Shao. Aryan Sharma. Sujay Sharma. Eric Shaw. Justin Shaw. Daisy Shea. Amara Shane. Alan Shen. Regina Shen. Dikila Sherpa. Leonid Shestakov. Alvin Shi. Christopher Shi. Fiona Shi. Sonja Shi. Aditya Shin. Benjamin Spetner. Leah Schwartz. Nicholas Xiao. Nosheen Sadiq. Shashwat Sigdal. Lamia Simran. Harshita Singh.
Congratulations on graduating. I'm so proud of us and I'm going to miss you all. I wish you the best of luck in college and beyond. And just remember, this is only the beginning. There's so much more to come.
Harshal Singh. Reba Singh. Charlotte Saragusa. Lars Smaland. Andrew Samsarjan. James So. Kwang Kant So. Tiffany So. Vishwa Sofit.
Congratulations on virtually graduating class of 2020. Thank you for a great 4 years and hold on to all those great happy memories, and I hope to see you all in person soon.
Ella Song. Irene Song. David Sontag. Wai Zing Su. Stefan Sorabe. Joshua Spector. Saujanya Sri Thirasarma. Timothy Stansberry. Sarah Stebbins. Jing Su. Amir Surawardi. Esther Suleimanov.
Congrats on graduating class of 2020. Hope you have a great summer.
Ahmed Sultan.
Hello, I just wanted to extend a big thank you to my family, my friends, especially those on the Malta UN team, and my teachers at Stuyvesant, and I'm happy to have graduated.
Arifa Sultana. Yi Hang Sun. Ju An Sur. Shakib Syed. Victoria Shimanovsky. Haley Tai. Tasfia Taj. Sunan Tajwar. Peter Tam. Christina Tan. Leon Tan. Manfred Tan.
I just want to thank my friends and family. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Samantha Tan. Samuel Tan. Sonia Tan. Jamie Tang. Melbourne Tang. Sarah Tang.
Thank you.
Sanjita Tanim, Shafaul Tanzeed, Ali Toby, Darian Taylor, Claire Templeman, Teresa Tang, Test Test Test, Alma Thaler, Jacqueline Tom, Alexander Thompson, Alexander Tran, Yufan Tong, Aaron Yukar, Matilda Urbaniak.
I just wanted to congratulate everyone on graduating in these crazy times, and I can't wait to see what we're all going to achieve with the rest of our lives.
Jeannie Van, Kieran Vuksanai, Vin Vung, Maximilian Walden, Emery Walsh, Albert Wan, Aaron Wang, Alicia Wang, Alan Wang, Bernard Wang.
Congrats, class of 2020. We survived 4 years of STI. Nothing can stop us now. Go do big things.
Calvin Wang, David Wang, Fei Wang, Jason Wang, Joyce Wang.
Thank you all for an amazing 4 years, and even though our journey at STI is over now, it will always have a special place in my heart, and I hope we can all stay in touch.
Kevin Wang, Kevin Wang, Penny Wang, Raymond Wang, Celine Wang, Steve Wang, Tiffany Wang, Yifan Wang, Jackson Warren Jew, Suhana Wasika, Solomon Wei, Andy Wang, Corey Wang, Eve Wenning, Ian Williams, Lewis Wallach, Benjamin Wong, Daniel Wong. Edward Wong. Evan Wong. Florence Wong. Javina Wong. Julian Wong. Kelly Wong. Kyle Wong. Lauren Huang. Stanley Wong. Victoria Wong. Wesley Wong. Betty Wu. Amy Wu. Anita Wu. Chen Yang Wu. Danny Wu. Jackie Wu. Jalen Wu. Jingwen Wu. Junghao Wu. Caitlin Wu. Shi Ting Wu. Simon Wu. Theodore Wu. Victor Wu. William Wu. Zhe Hong Wu. Anna Shah. Jasmine Shao. Lillian Shao. Simon Shia. David Shi Deng. Eric Xu. Kelsey Xu. Lan Xu. Yuan Ji Su. Bennett Xu. Amanda Yeagerman.
Hi everyone, it's Amanda. I just wanted to thank all the faculty, family, and friends who helped me get to the finish line. And bye, Stuy.
Kai Yamamoto. Vivian Yan. Wendy Yan. Colin Yang. Frank Yang. Helen Yang. Judy Xuan Yang. Song Hyun Yang. Shirley Yang. Susanna Yang. Alvin Jia Chun Yao, Samin Yassar, Jason Yi.
Well, the past 4 years have been great. Didn't end the way I expected it to, but it's been a fun ride. Stuy's gonna be in my heart forever, too. Smile.
Charlotte Yi. Elliot Yeo. Derek Yin. Erica Young. Catherine Yu. Eric Yu. Joseph Yu.
Hi, guys. Bye, guys.
Tiffany Yu.
Hey, guys. Congrats for graduating. It's been an amazing 4 years. We've been through many ups and downs. As we end a chapter of our lives, I want to thank my family and friends. Go, Class of 2020!
Yuhin Yu. Kelly Yuan. Kendrick Yuan. Nicholas Yun. Joseph Yusufov. Issa Zariah. George Zakin. Zoe Zakchevska. Aria Zaman. Nihaluz Zaman. Samina Zaman. Sarah Zaman. Greg Zborowski. Hillary Zen. Jia Tseng. Joanna Zhang. Ching Yi Zhang. William Zhang. Ben Zanker. Aldrich Zhang. Alex Zhang. Chelsea Zhang. Chen Tao Zhang. Daros Zhang. Derek Jang. Emily Jang. Helen Zhang. Joshin Zhang. Lu Shi Jang. Michael Jang. Vincent Zhang. Zi Yun Jang. Selena Zhao. Sophia Zhao. Susan Zhao. William Zhao. Xiaqi Zhao.
Stuyvesant is an unforgettable experience to me. I've grown a lot here. After all the stress and fun at Stuy, we made it. Congratulations to all of us.
Justin Zen. Amanda Zhang. Aubrey Zhang. Jackie Zhang. Jane Zhang. Jason Zhang. Jeffrey Chung. Joanna Zhang. Judy Zhang. Nicole Zhang.
Hey, Stuy Class of 2020, we finally did it. We made it through the quarantine. Now that we're graduating, I would like to thank my family, friends, and teachers for being there for me.
Patrick Zhang. Samantha Zhang. Tina Zhang. Veronica Zhang. Angela Zong. Daniela Zong. Kane Zhang. George Zhou. Joanna Zhou. Wei Ni Zhou. Christina Zhu. Claire Zhu. Colin Zhu. Sharon Zhu. Alexander Zhou. Evan Zhou. Jackson Zhou. Sharon Zhou.